Evening. Welcome to Candid Notes, and thank you for taking out time and joining us. I know you have back-to-back sessions, but we are very happy to have you here. Let me introduce quickly our Boston Marathoner and Super Enduroer, half Ironman, Army paratrooper, and of course, it's not just about fitness. Talk about ACADS, Rommel tops there as well. He's an IIM Lucknow alumni. So, and Rommel has managed to kind of coach a lot of national level mountain triathlon, you know, cycling and running and whitewater rafting sports and athletes. So that's brilliant. So we have here a super achiever who didn't leave any stone unturned. He just said, okay, let me just go all out for you. It. Welcome, Rommel. Welcome to Candid Notes. People are still struggling to see your, you know, smiling face. I always call him a smiling warrior. So we'll wait for that to happen, but we'll start the conversation for sure. So, Rommel, sure.
Thank you so much for the invite. It's been an absolute pleasure to be here. And thanks for the kind words. I don't think I really deserved all of those. And great to be here.
I think, that's called humility. People, when they are full, they've achieved. That's how it is, you know. So, Rommel, I always had this in my mind. There are a couple of times, of course, I can't claim to say I've run with you because that people are going to laugh at me. Oh, you can run with Rommel, really. But yes, I would say we've started a race together a couple of times, maybe training and the Delhi, half marathons and all. The thing that I've always, noticed and it struck me with me is your smile that is constantly there on your face, through and through. And, you're always in that Buddha state of mind when you're, at least for the person who's running with you, how do you manage that? I mean, something people would want to know that what is it going in your mind when you're actually running, and is there a mantra? Is there a chanting or is there a song or what are the thoughts?
See, Harini, actually the thing is I've always made it a point to enjoy my runs. The bottom line has been that anything comes, be it timing, be it whatever. So it's all secondary. If my timing is good, it makes sense. If it doesn't come, doesn't matter. I'm not going to spoil my happiness just because I'm going behind the timings. So that has been my clear motto in life, that if I have to run, I've got to enjoy each and every run I'm going to
enjoy my runs. Bottom line has been that anything comes, be it.
So with that as background, it was never a problem. All the runs, my short runs, long runs.
Enjoyed. Yeah, so basically, I know that you are, you pace. You also, you do pacing. You do when you're doing training runs. So these are three different kinds of runs, right? You're actually, training runs are a little relaxed, a little different, right? So what is the strategy for the race day as opposed to a pacer, as opposed to a training? Now, I'm asking this because I know a lot of runners who are extremely good and they're running for their timing. By the end of it, they're either collapsed and, or in a state of mind that they wouldn't want to see anybody's face. And I always feel that why are you doing an activity where you're pushing your limit to an extent where you're kind of killing yourself? And we don't even know if it's giving you pleasure, right? It's certainly not giving pleasure to the people around you. It's not a pleasurable moment to meet you post the run. So yeah, and I have seen that with you. You are through and through positive, smiling. So what is the key take you will give people for that?
Pacing an event is a totally different thing.
Because that time your
thought process is more focused towards people achieving their goals.
Right.
So that's why a pacer of 4 hours would journey be running on his personal event at a 3:30 or a 3:45.
Mm.
So that on the final day, he's able to motivate others and not just finish in 4 hours, if he's a 4 hour patient.
Sure.
So that becomes very, very important. So there's a lot of hard work which goes behind a pacer to make sure that people are able to achieve their aim.
True.
Now, as regards your own personal timing, generally people don't plan their races well. And that's why at the end of the, at the moment they reach the finish line, they collapse or something.
True.
So if you have planned your training and you know what to, expect, then things are very much in control.
True.
Right. So thought process while a final event in which you want to give a personal best is that you pace it in a manner that you finish it with a good feel and you get a personal best as well. So both the things are there.
True.
And normal training runs have to be easy until unless you are closer to the event and you are focusing more of speed workout. And speed workouts also are fun, but then it's only upon the attitude of the person. If he's feeling he's pushing too much, and but then if he's still happy, it doesn't make a difference, you know. If you're happy and you're pushing, then your attitude obviously would stay well. You stay happy. So that should not be a problem that you curse others or you feel bad doing that. So that doesn't hold through at all.
So, you know, the biggest deterrent in somebody's, you know, who wants to get back to fitness or continues, biggest deterrent, especially in case of running, is, you know, being judged. I always say that the speed is equivalent to the marks that you get in your school, right? I mean, when you start running and somebody says, oh, I can't run so fast. I can't, oh, I can only walk. Right. So I was just thinking that if you could give us a simple mantra, right, especially for kids and women. Right. And I feel that it's very essential for kids to get initiated very early on, but they find running very boring and all of that. So if you could help us, a simple mantra for people to kind of get started.
OK, so I'll cover it into two parts. First is the thing which you said that people start judging you, you know. If you see people judge you for whatever you do, it's not just running. So if you get bothered by people judging you with the kind of clothes you wear, with the kind of attitude you have, if you think too much about them, then you get stuck with those people itself. So what I have realized in life is let people think whatever they want. If they feel happy thinking something, let them feel happy. You know, you don't have to bother about what they are thinking about you. So let them think, let them judge you the way they want. If someone has to judge you, it's not just about running, as I said, they'll judge you on tens or thousands of other things. Just better to forget. Now, regarding children specifically, if you want to ask, children, whatever you may say, they'll not listen. That's the basic thing with the children. But then if they see you doing it, if you are getting involved in whatever they're doing, obviously they try and emulate it because they've seen it doing it. You, both the parents doing it, or in fact, even if one is doing, they tend to follow it in a much better manner rather than reading in it in books or somebody telling them that you get up in the morning in time and evening go for runs or morning go for runs. So it makes a lot of sense if you involve them in whatever activities you're doing. You know, and same thing goes for the ladies as well. If the lady is also getting involved in the things rather than only getting worried about my timing not improving, then, you know, obviously you are having a heartbreak. You don't feel good even if you're going for a run. So best part is avoid what people are thinking about you. Avoid the timing part also. Leave the watch at home also if it is required. If you're getting so very much conscious about it. So if you can do it, I think you're going to enjoy both the running part as well as getting disciplined with the children.
Perfect. So, you know, let me ask about you. How did it start for you? I know just for our viewers that you went into army, you know, and then the ACADS happened. Right, parallelly. But if I was to talk about your childhood, you know, were you always from a very fitness-centric family? Was it inculcated very early on? How did it start for you?
No, that was never the case. You know, I was kind of an average child, active, but then not into sports or anything like that. So things changed once I reached the training academy for the military. And once I reached there, then there was no option, you know. In army, you have to run. For that matter, Air Force or Navy as well. So once you reach there, then there are no options but to participate in those activities. Initially, I was horrible. Just like any other person who starts running, nobody is good. And I remember an incident, because you have taken this topic, that, you know, I started running with the army in 94. But then 2003-04, there was one cross country. And that was the only time I thought I've trained well by that time. So I could get good results. And in army, that time it was like first 10 would get recognition. After that, you don't get medals or something. Only the first 10 would be recognized that, okay, you guys have done well. That particular year, I had prepared well. So I thought I'll be among those first 10 people. So the moment we reached the turning point, it was a 11-kilometer cross country. The moment we reached the turning point, I was third, fourth. And then after the turning point, I realized people had started overtaking me because the strategy was better. I had burnt out by the time I reached the halfway mark. And I realized I was fifth, seventh, eighth, tenth. And I was, by the time there were 3 kilometers left, I was close to 13th, 14th. And I realized that either you come within 10th or then you are 50th or 60th, doesn't matter. So I started pushing myself. Accelerator pedal was full on. And 1 kilometer close to the finish line, I collapsed. I don't know what happened. And then when I got my senses, I was in the hospital. They said, you're having jaundice, you shouldn't have gone for the run, those kind of things.
Wow.
So everybody goes through that difficult times. And next year, again, I participated. And then that time I told my family, you know, I'll be more concerned about them and not just pushing so much that I land up in a hospital. So those things were there. And then slowly I realized, you know, since I used to enjoy what I was doing, so I improved. But then it took lots and lots of time. It was not that 1 year or 2 years. It took about 10 to 15 years to build up to a level.
Wow. So two things, Romil, my takeaway from this is, of course, you know, you're too humble. Somebody who's ordinary finishes third and fourth, and somebody who's, you know, as average as you is an ultra runner, is a marathoner, then it's reinforcing that that we should have army training for everybody. you know, they make people like you, then it should be compulsory for everybody, for sure. And the other thing which you very subtly and nicely put, which is for most of the people to take away, is it took you 10, 12 years, you know. So people usually get into, or, you know, once they start running, they want to do their full marathon within a year of running. Right?
Yeah.
So
that's the problem.
So that's probably because you want to do it too early on, and you know, so do you, going back to your, we were talking about kids, so do you also, how do you inculcate this? And I know you've got two kids, and you're spending a lot of time during the lockdown with them, and I remember that reading, you're enjoying this time with them. So how are you trying to enforce, do you really force it on them with them, you know, the fitness thing?
No, actually, so what is happening, since we are not able to move outside, so initially how we started was, I did a 1 week course with one of the institution, Pi School. So in that, I used to train children on online mode. So I had both my daughters as my demo pieces. So I used to take videos of them shooting, and then I used to tell the other children who are there on the other side, you know, this is the right way you should be following. And for that 1 hour, we realized, you know, both the daughters were enjoying, I was enjoying, a lot of my people who were there on the other side, they enjoyed. And then once it becomes a habit for 6 days, then we continue. And then we've been doing it very, very regularly. And every day evening, by the time it is 5:36, both my daughters are ready, you know, that, okay, papa time is there, let's go and start. So we put our mats, take our lemon water, all drills are set. And then we start training, and then we are really enjoying the time we are spending together, especially the exercise time.
Fantastic. So talking about teaching with them and, you know, following. So, you know, you said this is the right way. So people do have a form issue, right? Because I can talk from my own experience that I probably have the worst running form, right? But it's just that I was DEET, that I continued to run. So how important it is, and at what point one should start worrying about and you know probably consult somebody for a right running form?
Okay, so you know, this is again, if you go in depth, we realize if you are able to run without any injuries, any severe pains, that means your running form, even if it is bad, this is you. You've been running this or sure. having this kind of a form for so many years. You know, if I have a form, it's not that it has come last 1 month or so. It's like, let's say I'm 43. So last so many years, I've been running with that kind of a form. And if I'm able to sustain that, that means my body is accustomed to that kind of a running form. Now, if suddenly I change it, right from a forefoot landing to a midfoot or a heel landing, then it becomes a problem because muscles are not accustomed to that sort of a running.
Correct.
So in case I have a problem running with a heel landing or a midfoot landing, then I should consult a proper coach who is going to tell me. And there are a lot of people, you know, who are available. In your running group also, you realize there are a lot of people who are always ready to help. But then they'll only help once we ask them.
True.
You don't ask, we don't realize that what kind of problem the person is facing.
True.
So best part is you take help from people. Everybody learns from each other. Nobody is a born runner or nobody is a born person who can tell you what kind of running form one should have. It's all that we all learn from each other. And I've realized the running community is very helpful in this regard. So if you ask them, they'll be more than happy to tell you what should be the right form. At least I've been very lucky to meet such people who have always guided me. Be it short run, long runs, the kind of form I should have, the kind of shoes I should be wearing. So that way, I've been very lucky to have a good set of people who have guided me very well as regards whatever the training or diet has been concerned.
Good that you mentioned that word diet, Romil. So most of the people, I'm sure you hear it all the time that, you know, you know, you're from army. That's why you're able to do it so well. Oh, you're so disciplined. You know, you have a discipline of training. You have discipline of food. Do you also cheat? Do you cheat meals and do you indulge with your kids? You know, ki chalo aaj chaat khate hain. You know, does that happen or?
Yeah, definitely. So, but then, you know, it is there. But most of the time, we restrict ourselves to homemade kind of stuff. So, if we have to eat chaat also, we try and have it at home. And we avoid eating outside. So, whatever we have to consume, we do it inside our house. So, if we have to eat a pizza, we'll get a pizza base from outside, cook it inside our house, eat it, and whatever we eat. And one odd time, it's always, I mean, it's okay to cheat. There's no problem. Cheat days are in everybody's life. You know, we also have lots of ice creams. We also eat out. But then focus is to be inside whatever we have to do cheating. We have to do all together inside a house rather than going in a restaurant, multiplying the kind of things which we have once we are eating at home.
True.
So definitely, yes, cheat days are there. We eat chaat, you name a food, we have it. But then we have it in a better environment inside the house. It helps in, you know, having cleanliness and the kind of food you are eating, you know what is being there inside that food. So that's for sure is happens.
Perfect. So basically, guys, do cheat, but cheat in your limits. Romil, people talk about your success. Of course, you've done so many things. I'd like you to talk about one failure or one time that you were really broken and you had took a lot of effort for you to kind of bounce back. Because otherwise, you know, people think, okay, you know, you see only the success part of it. You don't see the hard work that goes behind it. So is there an incident you'd want to share?
So thing is, you know, if you ask any of my trainees who were, I mean, my training buddies who were there with me during the training days, they'll literally kill me if they see me. Because I used to really be very, very horrible in running and other aspects of life. So things changed in 2010. You know, whenever I go, these days I do a lot of talks, leadership, motivation and all. So I tell them, you know, my life when I was 34 changed. Before 34 was a different Roman. After 34, things made a 180 degree turn. So things were totally different. And that was the time I realized when I was 34, it was 2010. So if somebody asked me what have I done till then, I don't have anything to show, because those were kind of build up years, you know. You build up to a time, and then once you realize, then things change, or you realize you got to make certain changes in life to make a difference. You know, everybody wants that once they grow old, they should have stories to share. That what have they done in life? You should be answerable to your own self, if not to anyone else. So that thing came to me once I was in 2010. I realized, you know, I was not good at anything which I had tried my hand on. Be it running, be it academics. So nothing was making sense. I was moving without any direction. So 2010 was the time I said, no, things have to change. I worked very hard then. And from a third division in graduations, I cleared the master's at IIT Kharagpur. And then I joined there as IIT Kharagpur. And that was a turning point, you know. I could get that confidence, you know, that if I can do it after being a third division in college, then I should be able to do well in other aspects as well. And then I got, after Kharagpur, I came to Hyderabad and started running longer distances. And then because I tasted success as regard the academics is concerned, I could do well because that confidence carried on to running, then cycling, then other aspects of life as well. So the attitude completely changed.
Perfect. Romil, I'll quickly acknowledge a lot of our friends who've joined in Insta and FB as well. Sorry, guys. Unfortunately, you know, not able to break because we lost a little time in the middle. And again, Romil has a hard stop. But yeah, I can see Sundar from our events community. I have Deepika and Venkatana and Narsingh here. We have a lot of Facebook, we have a lot of your fans and a lot of people who've joined in. Thank you guys for joining in. We'll continue the conversation. We have a lot of musicians also, Romil, who are listening to you, singers. Shiva has joined in, you know, so welcome, guys. Going on to I talked about musicians. So, Romil, my connection with music is extremely strong, and we are only known for the kind of music we do. So, I wanted to know that what is the role of music in your life. Personally, I think everybody has some or the other, you know, they do listen to music. So what kind of music inspires you? You know, how often do you listen? Do you unwind with music?
Yeah, absolutely. So especially we being posted to different locations, we don't get a running group wherever we go. So, and once you're going for long runs or 10Ks, those kind of runs, you need something to stay motivated, you know, something to pep up once it is pretty warm in the afternoon or mornings. So you carry a headphone with music always on. So that way you stay focused, and then the kind of music you hear should be able to pump you up, you know, because otherwise it becomes very, very lonely at times. You keep running in difficult terrains because it's not flat all everywhere. So, and especially the kind of places you get posted to, you have very difficult terrains to run.
Sure.
So that is the time you listen to music, and it's very, very soothing. And especially for me, because I am from the kind of background I am, I like a lot of patriotic songs. Sure. In fact, my ringtone also conveys the same thing. I have a Lakshya movie song and those kind of songs which always push you up. And then once you are running, you can always relate any song to any of the incident in your life, considering the army background you have.
Absolutely.
So if you're listening to a particular song, you'll be able to relate to some situation you've had with your buddies, with something. And then these kind of songs always give you a high, and especially those songs like from Rocky Balboa, let's say. So anytime you hear to it, you feel, you know, you've got to tie up your laces, start running out. Similarly, there's songs from Chak De, movies like Bhaag Milka Bhaag. So these kind of songs really push you to do well.
So
these kind of songs are your company once you are running alone.
Absolutely. So we are going to create a small, Deepika saying the patriotic songs really bring in the josh, and you know, it can pump anyone up for sure. So we're going to create a small playlist of Romil's song and probably give it to you all, those who want to kind of get motivated with songs to begin with. Romil, a quick question on this. Is it advisable to have headphones on when you're kind of doing your running or walking, especially outside on the road?
Thing is, you know, it depends on the kind of training you are doing at that time. If you are in an environment where there is a lot of traffic, right? In our case, what happens, we have locations which have got a lot of area wherein there's no traffic at all, a lot of lonely places, a lot of parks and all, it's okay. Though if you are focusing too much on a form, then it is again advisable to not listen to the kind of headphones and all. But then if you're doing a normal run wherein you're not focusing too much on the speed or other aspects, then it is okay. Because if you're running for 2 hours, 3 hours, and that too solo, then you need something to keep you fresh, something to stay focused. So that way it is fine. But then if you're running in a city like Hyderabad or Delhi, and that too in traffic, obviously, got to be sensible enough not to wear headphones. Not visible.
So, I know, Romil, you've been mentoring people a lot. I know you, in fact, you're very, very welcoming, very edimary with a question. You're always there to help people. But aren't you looking at, I think high time we're all waiting for you to become a coach. So, when is that happening?
See, mentoring is something I really enjoy, because I've learned so many things and we all learn from each other. So, it gives a lot of satisfaction as regards whatever you have achieved. Because in my case, I remember the moment we decided we were going to do Everest, there were a lot of people I interacted, all the Everesters I interacted, what kind of things are there, how the training should be. Similarly for running, once I joined 2012, I reached Hyderabad, I used to eat everybody's brain, how to train. And then there was a point where I had trained for Mumbai Marathon for a complete year. 2014, I did 3:28. 2015, I did 3:28 and I was shattered. I could never believe 1 year has gone to drain. This was the kind of feel I had. I have trained very well for 1 year, but then the results have been same. So then that was the time I realized, I need to have proper coaching. And then that was the reason I had a coach, very, very nice guy. He trained me real hard. And that's what the reason I could do from 3:28 to 3:10. And the way you were saying, people judge you. So I remember there was one guy just before the marathon, about a week prior to that, a so-called guru, I asked him, I've done a 3:28, I want to do it 3:10. So this guy tells me, are you dreaming or you actually worked for it? I said, no, let the results speak in that case. And luckily I was able to do that. So if you have a proper guidance, it surely helps you. I'm just waiting for another, maybe a month or two, and then I'll be, I think I'll be doing my bit for the running community into coaching.
Yeah, we're eagerly waiting to see you as a coach here. So for all our non-runners, just to quickly give you, to begin with, shaving off few seconds and of course minutes is a big deal. Somebody if able to reduce 1 minute in their speed, or reduction of 10 minutes anyways is extremely high. So yeah, just to get the perspective right. Every second counts. So Romil, quickly, we're going to have some of your rapid fire questions with you. So describe yourself as a teenager in 3 words.
That's a difficult one.
You can
totally useless guy.
Oh, please.
You've got to meet me in that phase of life, you would realize I was absolutely dumb.
So there is a question from one of the viewers. Is it correct that it's better to increase distance first than speed?
Absolutely. Speed is just not required. It's just the distance. Only thing is it should not be that somebody listens to this and says, okay, Romil has said distance, tomorrow we'll do a 10K or a 15K, not required. You've got to see where you stand and then you build up. So speed and all is all for professionals. If you're starting, if you're an amateur, like most of us are, so you only need to enjoy your runs and be consistent. And believe you me, if you do these two things, just enjoy your runs and be consistent, you're surely going to improve, even if you're not doing any speed workout. This is for sure. I can vouch for it anytime. So just go out, enjoy, be disciplined enough to go. I remember there were a lot of times when I didn't feel like going and I used to say, okay, I'll go out, run for 5 minutes, come back. But then believe you me, there's never been a case I've gone out and then I've come back after 5 minutes. I just used to make up my mind that, okay, I'll only do 5 minutes and come back.
Fantastic.
Never happened.
So he's saying, never put happened. Smaller goals, push yourself, don't aim for big thing. That'll eventually happen. Somebody has written that he's still young, so no wonder people know you very well, Romil. You're still very young, they've written. Of course he is. Okay, so one thing that you'd want to do soon after the lockdown that you're really waiting for, of course apart from running, that we know that you'd want to go out and run, but over apart from that.
No, we're going to have a good family outing for some time because kids have been really, really in a big pain, you know, inside the house for 2 months, that too at that age. For us, it's still understandable. We understand these things. But then for children, I think they've got to step out and just roam around for some time.
Hmm. What is your comfort food?
Comfort food? Anything home-cooked food is fine. Anything cooked at home. Love it.
So somebody is asking, when are you doing your Ironman?
So I did a half Ironman 2013.
Yes.
In fact, that was, I got a podium in that. But then only thing is I didn't feel the need because one sport, running itself takes so much of a time. So if you've got True. To do running, you've got to do swimming, you've got to do cycling as well, then you will not be able to do justice with so many things. And if you've got to do something, might as well do it nicely. But then I've never been able to get out of running. So it's difficult to focus on other sports. So that's the reason I've not been focusing much on triathlons.
Plus average people only get podium.
No, nothing to that. It's just that running itself just is so interesting. You don't want to lose your time because you'll have to cut down on running time if you're doing
Agree. Exactly. So some of you for Ironman is basically you need to do swimming, running and cycling, all three. And all three would need equal amount of dedication, equal amount of expertise. So that's what Romil says when he says that, you know, he will have to cut down on the time that he's spending in running to be able to dedicate it to swimming and cycling. Hence, he wants to hold himself back. I'm sure he can do it anytime he wants, but he's waiting for the right moment.
Right.
So Romil, anything that you're very picky about, you're very particular about? It's rapid fire. You have to be quick.
No, I'm not that fast as you know. You
guys. Just kidding.
Nothing at all.
I thought it was answer.
I'm kind of laid back. Whatever comes, it's okay. It's good for us.
No, you call that accommodating. Okay, one thing that annoys you, you know, one thing that can put you off in a person.
Cheating.
Perfect. Anybody that you admire the most, anybody who's your role model, anybody, it doesn't have to be a runner, sports person. It could be from any field or it could be just non-achiever, but somebody that you really admire.
No, there are a lot of people. So to start with Steve Jobs, I think there's one speech he gave, you know, that was convocation speech. Mm-hmm. So I've heard it thousands of times. I've shown it to my children as well. So in which he says about, stay hungry, stay foolish. Big impact. Mm. If all the viewers must go, have a look at the YouTube video. Steve Jobs' convocation speech. It's amazing. Must have a look.
True. So do you watch movies? Which is your favorite movie?
Favorite movie?
Other than
Lakshya. Recently I watched the movie Bareilly Ki Barfi. Oh, amazing. I really loved it.
Oh, yeah. It is quite cute. So yes, I was just coming to the favorite actor or a favorite star. I was just coming. That
yeah,
would have been my
name.
Right. And female star, favorite female star.
Deepika Padukone.
Not bad. Perfect. So I think, you know, I need 3 more sessions with you because I think there are a lot of questions people wanted to ask. We couldn't entertain. There are people and you have a hard stop, but it's been an absolute pleasure talking to you and thank you for enlightening us. So, you know, one last message to all our audience who are watching us. Because we want more and more people to take fitness seriously, get into it, especially kids, women owe it to themselves. So one message that you'd want to give.
Right. So, you know, running, we don't have to complicate the thing. So if I've really learned a lot from running, and I encourage people to do it, you know. And the only reason I do it, because I've enjoyed my journey. Past so many years I've been running, I've enjoyed it and I've benefited. So I want everybody else to do. Only problem comes once you become greedy. You know, remember that there are no shortcuts. Whatever you're seeing in other person, is the version which you have seen only from the outside. The hard work which has gone behind is not visible. So that's why you feel, you know, if you train for shorter time, you'll be able to succeed. Forget about it. Just go out, enjoy, tie your shoelaces, go out for a run. You're going to have a great time. Make it a habit. And I'm sure you'll surely improve. Even if you don't improve, doesn't matter. Aim should be longevity, that you should be able to run for as long as possible. There's no point having being a hero for 2 years, not being able to run after that at all. So have patience, enjoy. And if you keep this thing in mind to enjoy your runs, you'll surely do well. That's more than I had to say.
So one more last thing which I ask for the viewers is, Are you willing or you're ready for online coaching? Because thanks to the lockdown time, would you want to start creating, you know, smaller capsules or easier capsules for people to kind of get motivated and start?
Yeah, sure. You know, I think that's something which is going to be in future as well. So I had a course I did about 15 days back. That was a 1 week course. I really enjoyed it. Sure. Kids also enjoyed it. Everybody enjoyed it. Very good feedback was there. So I think it's going to come up. It's going to take some time as of now. But then once the mechanism is ready, I'm surely going to do that.
Sure. Thanks a lot, Ravil. Thanks again for being here. And it was a pleasure talking. Unfortunately, our Insta viewers couldn't see you. They're saying that, you know, even I couldn't see. I could see you through the Facebook. But our Facebook viewers can see you and hear you. Thanks a lot. This was really an amazing session. And we will sure have one more.
No, thanks so much, Arine. It was absolute pleasure for me as well. Thanks a lot.
Thank you guys for joining in. All those are Insta friends, our running community, events community, musicians community. We had variety of audience. It's absolute pleasure. We'll see you next week with our candid notes. Thank you.